Welcome at Makumu. Yeah, the book about the story of Makumu was actually written already in 1973, when I was a 16-year-old boy and my father took me to the bush where he was invited to the Glaceri. And I must tell you, I fell in love with the bush immediately. And although I was a little boy or a young boy, yet I enjoyed that idea of the bush so much that I had already decided one day I'm gonna be a ranger, one day I want to own a lodge. And then, luckily enough, through my business career in the truck and trailer business, I could travel to South Africa once, twice, three times a year. And in the meantime, my friend also bought a lodge in the Glaceri, and I could enjoy his place whenever I was in South Africa, or even when I took my family finally by myself. So everything happened learning by doing. And over two decades, I really got so much knowledge and ideas about how to live in the bush and how to actually a lodge should look like, that in 2001 I could purchase this present property, and in 2002 Makumu was built completely from scratch. So it's everything is designed, and the ideas about the boma, about the view, about the decoration and the interior design came from me and my family. And yeah, so we enjoyed Makumu for almost 15 years just with the family and friends. When we came into a situation where friends of mine said, "Ach, we can't take invitation all the time. Can't we come and bring our friends or families?" And we were thinking and said, "Hey, why not actually become commercial, generally speaking, so we can make better use, so we can share our passion, we can share the excitement of that individual private home with all our future guests." And with that, it gave me the chance to be here much more often than in the past, meaning 6 months, where I'm actually enjoying the guests by myself, sometimes do even the game drive, and with that, it's a lifetime experience. I'm very happy about that decision, and it works quite well. As this place was never created as a commercial lodge, it is very different. It was built with the emotions and the dream of how should a game lodge look like. And so it's totally different when you share a place like this. It's a home which we share with guests, and fortunately it was already built to the size of up to 12 guests, which we can now easily host. And the infrastructure was perfect for sort of running it all year instead of just a few months. And yes, this is exactly our idea. And beside the fact of that home, it is very, very important for me that we keep the privacy not only here in the lodge, where you can look like 80 kilometers to the Drakensberg without seeing any lights or any other pollution. It is essentially important to me that the bush remains private, and that means it's only our vehicles out there. We do have a bit of an agreement with our neighbors for special sightings, but here you will mostly run into a sighting just yourself, your family, friends, or partner, or whatever, and that is something I definitely wish to obtain. So in other words, the 12 guests, two vehicles, six people at a time on a vehicle, that's it. And that sort of package gets you that feeling of I'm in the bush and it's just me, and you really smell that out of Africa sort of feeling. And that's of course the idea, beside all the details, beside the enjoyment of being out here, enjoying the endless view, enjoying the poolside, enjoying your room, sitting in the hammock with a book. And it's a vacation place in itself, with the power of and energy of the bush. Likewise, I wish to mention that beside the privacy of the bush, when we do our game drives, it is also important, and we like to teach and guide our guests into the direction that it's not purely the Big Five. We do have the Big Five, and we do see them regularly, and even just on a two-night stay, you have a big chance to see all the Big Five. But that's not what we here for. So we're not just hunting the big five with lots of vehicles and radio and where is it, where can we have an exciting sighting. No, it's definitely more than this, and we want to show people a lot about nature. That is also the small big five. It can be a dung beetle to a spider to even a fly or an ant. Yeah, regarding Eyes of Africa, this is because my passion was not only South Africa. It was in a way because of, as I mentioned, flying over from Europe to Johannesburg so many times in my life. I once was sitting actually at the Boma of Makumu and thought about what is a continent? What does it look like? I would love to see it with the eyes of a bird flying over the continent. And fortunately, in 2006, I could manage together with a technician and pilot crew and Michael Politzer, who did the photographical scenery, to fly from Hamburg to Cape Town in an incredible adventure helicopter trip, which has been unique, I think, even up to now. And we could experience 19 different countries in 9 weeks, 150 landings and takeoffs, and endless many impressions which stay up here in my brain. And I have to say, moments like landing on Eta Ale, one of the very few active craters in the world at Ethiopia, spending a full day with a local tribe, seeing their local habits, which you never got to see as a tourist, was just outbreaking. And I'm very glad I could afford and manage a trip like this, and thank you to the team, of course, but it was a great experience. South Africa still remains for me the most fascinating and appreciated country. I've seen it now in over four decades, and I've seen it going from apartheid to a liberal country. Liberal, of course, in an African sense, but it's amazing to see how Johannesburg looks today, and going back in the early 80s where I lived in Johannesburg, it is amazing, and I love to see how the nature of the local population opens up, and I personally have only good memories. And I know the PR work is rather not always positive regarding South Africa, but I can only say, with the right sort of appearance and the right way to go and live in this country, it is very, very, very beautiful and nice and also safe. I like to mention this as well, because I obviously get asked that question, oh, isn't it unsafe here? And I haven't had any problems so far in over 40 years, and I'm quite thankful for that. So finally, all I can say is Makumu is great, and you should take a chance and come and enjoy the bush the way we think it's the way to go. And I promise you, it's all based on that passion and experience from a long, long time out here, and you will for sure enjoy the lot. Copy.